Higher numbers always mean better, right? Especially with Apple products. Well, that might not be the case with the M2 versus the M1 Pro MacBook Pro models. So as you know, there's been lots of leaks and rumors flying around recently, and I made quite a few videos on them, basically saying that M2 is on its way. And a lot of YouTube creators and a lot of bloggers out there are also saying the same. Check out some of these leaks that we've had. So first of all, one of the first leaks that we had that M2 was possibly coming very soon, and most likely around March time, was from DigiTimes. DigiTimes claimed that an M2 MacBook Pro was on its way. And to be deadly honest, a lot of us, including myself, kind of ditched this idea completely. Why on earth would Apple bring out the M2 chipset when they haven't actually finished rolling out the M1 Pro and the M1 Max chipset into the likes of, say, the Mac Mini and also, say, the iMac or the iMac Pro, whatever comes out? It just doesn't seem logical. But since then, we've had loads more reports coming in. So, for example, we had the report come in from the guy who claimed that at the last minute that the MacBook Pros from last year, the 14-inch and 16-inch one, would get notches, has also said there is going to be an M2 MacBook Pro coming on the early half of this year, most likely at the March event. And then we also got another leak again from Mark Gurman, who's basically confirmed, yep, you're going to be getting an M2 MacBook Pro coming at March time, and there's also going to be lots of other devices throughout the year that are going to be getting the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. And that basically, that includes those iMacs, those Mac Minis, and those Mac Minis could possibly be a variant of getting M1 Pro inside it, or the M1 Max, and also an M2 chipset. And he's also claimed that we would also get an M2 MacBook Air. Then finally, we had some solid proof that we're going to be getting some new Macs, most likely at the beginning half of this year, in the Eurasian database, where we had the registration of two desktop models and also a MacBook model. So it's very clear and quite likely we're going to be getting the M2 chipset, and also it seems very likely that it's going to be a brand new MacBook Pro with that M2 chipset. Now, when we look back at some of those leaks, it's actually claiming that this new M2 MacBook Pro is actually going to be put inside the 13-inch MacBook Pro that we have right now. This is the Touch Bar design MacBook Pro that we've had for probably about 5-6 years, and it's looking likely it's going to be pulled out again and an M2 chipset is going to be put inside it. Now, straight away, I know a lot of you are disappointed we're not getting a brand new design, but you've got to remember, to keep costs down, Apple don't want to redesign this model, and also at the same time as well, they don't have to redesign a new manufacturing process for a brand new design altogether. They can keep on using the same manufacturing process, same workers, people who know what they're doing with this design, and just slap an M2 chips in it. It makes things cheaper for you guys, and you've got to understand that. A new design would be great, but also understand on the other side of it that Apple, what they're doing is keeping this design to make sure it keeps the cost down and that, yeah, you can still get that great performance. And talk about performance, a question you're going to be asking, well, is M2 going to be better than M1? Well, yes, of course it's going to be better than M1. The standard M1 chipset we got out in 2020, yes, the M2 is definitely going to be faster in every way than the M1. But the next question you're going to be asking, is the M2 going to be better than the M1 Pro and the M1 Max? Well, straight away, I'm going to squash M1 Max. M1 Max is definitely going to be M2. But with M1 Pro, it can be a slightly bit of a different story. But what about that lowest spec sort of M1 Pro chipset out there? The one, if you buy the cheapest 14-inch MacBook Pro out there right now, the 8-core version and with the 14-core GPU. Well, it depends. And the best way I can show this is doing a breakdown of showing the difference between the M2 and also the M1 Pro, that 8-core version. So starting with the M2, what we've been told is we will get an 8-core CPU, and again, that will be made out of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. But compared to the actual GPU, things are going to be different this year. Instead of getting an 8-core GPU like we got with the M1, we've been told we're actually going to be getting a 10-core GPU, so an additional 2 more cores. And Apple liked to do this quite a lot recently. With the iPhone 13 Pro models, for example, they got 1 extra GPU core compared to the standard iPhone 13 and the iPad Mini, for example. So yes, Apple could be doing the same here with the M2. So it looks really good that the graphical power is going to be much more better than what we got with the M1, especially with those more cores. But then comparing this to the likes of that 8-core M1 Pro, what do we get there? Well, the big difference is that yes, we do get 8 cores, but it's how those 8 cores are set up. The difference is we get 2 efficiency cores, but we actually get 6 performance cores. So that's a big difference to 4 and 4 and 2 to 6. So straight away, even though the M1 Pro is going to be an older generation, it's possibly that the M1 Pro is going to be faster, and I'm going to show this in some Geekbench scores. But for GPU, things are different again. With GPU, the lowest that you get is 14-core GPU with that $2,000 14-inch MacBook Pro. So again, we're going to be getting 14 cores, and comparing that to the 10 cores, yes, it's definitely going to be probably better. So what I'm planning to do is show some benchmarks to you guys just in a second, comparing the M2 to this M1 Pro 8-core version. But before we do that, I want to talk about the giveaway that we're doing on the channel right now. And it's for this. It's for an iPhone 13 Pro Max in silver white, a 256GB model. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 350,000 subscribers. And all I want to know for you guys to be in the chance of being to get your hands on this iPhone in this international giveaway is right down in the comments below of what Apple gear, or what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. Write it down in the comments below, and when we get over 350,000 subscribers, I'll be revealing who the winner is of this iPhone 13 Pro Max. So if you are new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell, because you'll want to get that notification to find out if you're the lucky person of this iPhone 13 Pro Max. Also, at the same time, I just want to mention there are lots of scammers, there are lots of spammers out there, some of them impersonating me, to telling you to Telegram them or to WhatsApp them. This is not me, and I will not be doing that for this iPhone 13 Pro Max. Like I said, I'll be making a video when we get over 350,000 subscribers, and only then. With that out of the way, let's have a look at some benchmarks then, and what we're going to do is we're going to compare it to the MacBook Pro M1, and we're also going to compare it to the MacBook Pro 14-inch with an M1 Pro 8-core version, and then we're also going to compare that to the M2 chipset of what we've been told so far, and using the likes of the A15 to the A16 chipset, and what it looks like the jump's going to be between those two chipsets, we're going to forecast what the M2 is probably going to give us. Because basically, looking on what we got with the A14 to the A15, it wasn't a big jump, but you'll see what I mean when we do these benchmarks. So let's start then with a Geekbench score and a single core score. So first of all, as you can see here, we have the MacBook Pro M1 at the bottom, then we have that M1 Pro MacBook Pro next of all in the middle, and then we have the predicted M2 above that. And as you can see here, the difference between the M1 and the M1 Pro in single core is hardly any different. There's a 2% difference, nothing really in it. However, with single core performance with M2, it is looking likely, compared to the M1 Pro 8-core version, that we're going to be getting an increase of a 7% single core speed. Now, that might not seem a lot, but when you come and look at multi-core score now, this is where things change quite a bit, especially with that single core difference of 7%. So looking at the multi-core score, you can see there's a 22% difference between the M1 and the M1 Pro. Now, like I did say earlier on in this video, the M1 has 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, whereas this M1 Pro 8-core version has 2 efficiency cores and 6 performance cores. So you can see why we're getting a 22% difference. But the amazing thing is what M2 is doing for us this time round. Yes, it's looking likely that M2 is going to be about 9% less powerful than compared to that 8-core version of the M1 Pro. But like I said again, the M2 is going to be made up of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. But yeah, it's only going to be around about 9% slower than what we have with the M1 Pro, what has far more performance cores. And that's absolutely amazing to see. But moving on to the Geekbench 5 Metal score, this is where things change quite a bit. And remember, we're talking about GPU cores now. So the M1 has 8 GPU cores. But remember, the M1 Pro, the cheapest one that you want to get, has 14 GPU cores. That is quite a lot more, and that's why we're getting such a big difference of 64% in more power in GPU performance. But then again, compare this to the M2. Remember, the M2 is looking likely we're going to get a 10 core GPU, but the difference here is quite amazing, that we're only going to be getting a 16% difference. So M2's GPU is going to only be 16% less than compared to the 14 core GPU that we get in the M1 Pro, and that's absolutely amazing. Now straight away, it does prove the point here that overall that the M1 Pro is better. But when we look at the single core and what we also see that we're getting with M2 over M1, the original, we're getting quite a big difference here. And to be honest, if you look at this next chart that I've done, you may recognize it from one of my previous videos where I did a Final Cut Pro export on a 16-inch MacBook Pro with an i9, a MacBook Air, and also the M1 14-inch MacBook Pro with the 8 cores with the export times. And it's quite amazing what actually happened, especially between the MacBook Air and also the 14-core GPU MacBook Pro. As you can see here, the difference between them was just over 30 seconds. And probably where M2 is going to sit is going to sit probably in the middle, or probably more closer to the side of the M1 Pro 8 core or the 14 core GPU model. So to be honest, there's really not going to be much in it. It's probably going to probably take about 10 seconds or 12 seconds more to export the same video on M2 to the M1 Pro. And that is absolutely amazing. Now, a good reason why I find this amazing is, yes, like I did talk about, we're going to be probably getting that same design MacBook Pro, but we're going to get M2 put inside it in that 13-inch model. But that model only costs us $1,299, and it's likely that Apple probably won't increase the price of this model. But yet, the 14-inch MacBook Pro starts out at basically $2,000, and that is a big difference. And that's what I'm trying to get my point over here. For $700 in performance wise, you're getting something very close to something that costs $700 more. So in my opinion, for performance wise, the MacBook to choose, definitely pick the 13-inch MacBook Pro. However, what I will say is, I'm not saying I'm a massive fan of the 13-inch MacBook Pro. With that 14-inch MacBook Pro, it is basically the ultimate package. You get that mini LED display, you get ProMotion, you get those extra ports, you get all of that extra kind of cooling, and you also get a slightly bit more of a power boost on the likes compared to the MacBook Pro with the 13-inch, and also one of my personal favorites, you get MagSafe as well. But can you justify that for $700? Well, I guess that's up to you. But personally, in my opinion, for performance alone and bang for your buck, the amount of money you're spending on performance-wise and what you're getting, definitely the 13-inch MacBook Pro, if it does come out this March time, and also having an M2 chipset inside it, is definitely going to be worth it. Well, with all of that all together, it's time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.